so this is once again my topic for the next stage of writing discussion paper. The title is Effectiveness of Islamic-based Materials, Improving English Skills of the Students of Islamic-based in Indonesia. So the general idea is that to provide Islamic content of English materials in the teaching of teaching of English to Muslim students. So this is my background, not only for studying but also for working. So besides I'm teaching in an Islamic university, so you must know that there are a lot of Islamic universities in Indonesia. Because of that fact, so I'm thinking about to provide the best or the relevant, most relevant materials for students in those universities. So this one is the slide picture of how a Muslim or an Islamic class is about. So English is now very important in the world, not only in Indonesia. But do you think English is very important? Yeah, I think so. So because of the status of English in nowadays, it's very important. So we now have to think about how to teach this language to our students, especially to Muslim students. And you know what, that English, the teaching of foreign language usually bring the idea or the values or the culture of the owner of this language. So there are many, I think the time is not running. So yeah, I forget to.
It's funny because the other ones worked.
Yeah, maybe because I missed this. Okay, so you must know that several languages, like not only English but also Spanish, French, have become have spread around the world because of the past history of these languages. So, like English Empire or British Empire have colonized the several parts of the world, also the French and also the Spanish, Spain, Spanish people. So because of that imperialistic history, the languages have spread around the world. So because language sometimes brings the values or the culture of the owner of the language. So you can see from this slight figure of English composition. So like the way how they give names to people. So this is the names of English people, right? So we don't really know that those names are names because we never hear that thing in our country, for example. And also several materials, English materials, content have that kind of infamous, not famous figures in our lives, like the previous one. So I'm here offer to not only me, several English practitioners and teachers in Muslim environment offer to give Islamic context in the teaching of English, because our community have already the knowledge of Islam and also several figures in Islam. So it will make them easier to understand the context. So there will be only the language or English language to be the last. done this.
For my benefit, can anybody question or
our criticisms?
Yeah,
we are is it too boring or is it too humble or?
I think your presentation style was really nice. Yeah, very relaxed, very calm.
Yeah.
Maybe you can use your hands a little bit more.
Yeah.
Okay, can I ask some questions and maybe get some feedback from everybody about it? Because I'm still a little bit unclear. Is it really a problem? Because it seems like you're saying all you got to do is put some famous Islamic leaders instead of like Albert Einstein or Elvis Presley or Indonesian or Islamic famous people. And maybe instead of saying George and Jimmy, you'll say
surface.
Is it debatable? I don't think anybody would disagree with you. I think people would disagree with that the first person in space was a woman, but no. But I think nobody would disagree that you can. However, if I was learning Indonesian in Australia, right, and many people do learn Indonesian, I think it would be strange if all I learned about was Australian people speaking Indonesian, and I didn't learn anything about Indonesian culture. And so all the names are John and Jeff, and they're all speaking Indonesian, I think. And because if I had learned Indonesian, you learn about Indonesian food, Indonesian culture, Indonesian religion, Indonesian names. And I'd expect this, and if everything was changed into English, I think I'd feel a bit, and then I went to Indonesia, I think, wow, wait, all these weird names, why? So you're saying that
that's a very important question. I think that's what we must ask him. introduce them about us. So that is the purpose of learning language. If you cannot say anything, you cannot say who you are. So that is the most important aspect of learning.
Okay, we have to move on. I think it's interesting, but I'm going to challenge you.
Yes, yes.
But don't get me wrong, I'm not disagreeing, I'm just...
Yeah.
Yes, I know.
And because I think you're kind of missing the deep issue. And if you read Gararajana and Betty Cook, you see that actually it's quite... It goes beyond just learning about English names or English.
Yes.
It's actually the whole idea that everybody is feeling like they're under pressure to learn an English language and that the cultural values is passing, whether it does threaten Islamic culture or Christian culture as well. So it's actually, I think you have to go a little bit deeper.
I was trying to finish my reading to those guys, but.
Yes, it's like I understand it's very complex. And it's very deep, but there's another layer, because you'll be criticizing English language, but your criticism will be using Western concepts to criticize. And even in criticizing, you're using the Western concept of critical thinking. So it's like you're going to be going around, which for me is interesting, but for you is difficult.
Yeah,
I look forward to it. That's really good. You've got a lovely presentation style as well. So good luck with that.
Okay.